discuss the second order transient response. So this particular is the last in the series of transient response. Likewise, so a simple circuit is shown here with consisting of resistance, inductance and the capacitance. Likewise, so previously in the first order circuit we have gone through. So this particular is a equation of a general step response characteristic of a RC circuit consisting of a resistance and the capacitor. So here say this particular is a general solution, A e to the power minus t upon tau, where say the coefficient of integration A is obtained by the initial conditions. Using this particular relationship, when say we are extending it to a little general arrangement, for the RC circuit, the capacitor voltage is expressed as V of infinity plus V of 0 minus V infinity e to the power minus t upon tau. So point here is that with the help of final response, which is the V infinity, and the initial response V0, we are able to get the complete response of the RC circuit. And this particular coefficient of integration is obtained by the initial conditions. Likewise, on the similar line, we have also extended for the RL circuit. So this particular, the inductor current is expressed like this, I of t is equal to I infinity plus I 0 minus I infinity e to the power minus t upon tau. So for the RC circuit, first is to obtain the capacitor voltage, then compute the other parameter of interest if needed, and for the RL circuit, first calculate the inductor current and then calculate the other parameters of interest. The tau is the time coefficient, time constant, so that particular is well defined. For the RC, it is the RC, and for the RL circuit, it is L upon R. Now, when say we are going for the second order response, the computation of the integral constant or the coefficient which are participating after the integration are to be calculated in a little different manner. So that particular is, or you can say, will be clear to you likewise, but the point here is that we have to give note how we will be calculating the coefficient of integration for the different systems likewise. Now, as we have gone through for the first order circuits, we will also be studying the second order response in the same fashion, first considering the free response or the natural response, and then we will be going for the forced response analysis likewise. So this forced response is also regarded as the step response. So in this particular free response, there is no external source to support the transient behavior. However, it is a separate issue that the initial inductor current I0 or the initial capacitor voltage V0 has been acquired before the response is analyzed. So you can say, if we are considering the time t is equal to 0 as a switching, then the I0 and V0 are pertaining to the conditions just before the switching likewise. So that particular is regarded as the t is equal to 0 minus, so that is the before the switching, and correspondingly we will be having say the inductor current I0 and capacitor voltage V0. We have made it clear that the current in the inductor cannot change momentarily. So whatever say the 0 minus, the current at 0 minus will be equal to the at 0 plus. Similarly, the capacitor voltage at time t is equal to 0 minus will be the capacitor voltage at time t is equal to 0 plus likewise. Now the KVL equation for this is a simple arrangement, Vr plus Vl plus Vc is equal to 0. So Vr is the R into I, inductor voltage Vl is equal to L di upon dt, and the capacitor voltage 1 upon C I dt is equal to 0. So this right hand side is 0 because there is no external source likewise. Now here say the integration is participating. So when say we are having a current as such. Now first initial values which are known to us, that is to be like this. So they are before the circuit conditions. But when say we are writing the at time t is equal to 0 plus, what we have seen that the current I will be because of the inductor current, that is not changing momentarily. Vc is the capacitor voltage that is remaining unchanged with the switching, or you can say at 0 plus. So the dy dt is to be calculated likewise. So here say it is a departure from what has been studied in the first order case. So carefully we are writing the KVL or say the KCL equations and finding out the derivative of current or the voltage as the case may be, likewise at time t is equal to 0 plus. So now the previous equation is differentiated again. So that particular is resulting into the second order equation in terms of the current as variable, time dependent parameter likewise. This equation is rearranged into the standard form. So we will be writing the equation in such a manner that the derivative powers are coming out to be decreasing as we are moving from left to the right. So as say the d square I upon dt square, it is a second order derivative, di upon dt which is a first order derivative. So when say we are invoking, this is resulting into a characteristic equation s square plus r upon l s plus 1 upon l c likewise. So as you can emulate like say di upon dt. Now this particular characteristic equation is written into a standard form. So these are, you can say, the standard form in terms of a nomenclature. The same equation can be written into a different form. So omega n stands for the natural frequency. Zeta is a term which is related to the damping. And if you are making a correspondence, then the alpha value is equal to the zeta omega n. So this particular characteristic equation is of the second order. So that is giving rise to the two roots S1 and S2. So that is, we will be able to simply calculate by the standard equation. So there should not be any ambiguity. Now as we have defined the alpha, so R upon 2L is the alpha value. So this particular is giving rise to the equation likewise, minus alpha plus root of alpha square minus omega n square likewise. Now when say we are defining the natural frequency, that is 1 upon root of LC and alpha likewise, so you can define the damping ratio or damping coefficient likewise, so that is alpha upon omega n. Now this particular characteristic equation as explained in the previous arrangement, so it is having say the two roots, they are summed up likewise. Now here the condition either decided by the alpha or decided by the zeta is classifying the equation into the three cases. One is the overdamped case. So in the overdamped, the damping is greater than 1. That comes out to be when say the alpha is greater than omega n. Critically damped, when say alpha is exactly equal to the omega n or damping is equal to 1. And the underdamped, when say the alpha is coming out to be less than omega n, or you can say that damping is less than 1. So on these cases, the value or nature of the S1 and S2 will be different. And when say the S1 and S2 are different, so will be the general solution. Now please be mindful that we are considering here the case of natural response, or you can say the source free response. So simply consider that the S1 and S2, whatever we have obtained previously, they are written as it is. When say the value of alpha is greater than omega n, so this square root is constituting the positive value. That particular is giving rise to the two roots S1 and S2 and so on. Now second point which we have to make clear, that the square root value or square root of alpha square minus omega n square will be lower than the alpha value. So ultimately S1 will be negative and S2 negative. So what is the conclusion? That roots are real and negative but different. So that particular is an important observation for the overdamped. Now when say the roots are coming out to be of negative and the real, so that particular is giving rise to a decaying, exponentially decaying response, and that decreases to the zero value as the time progresses. So please be mindful here, say the S1 is coming out to be negative, so the general expression it will be k1 e to the power s1t and k2 e to the power s2t. So out of these two value, the S2 is coming out to be large negative, S1 is coming out to be smaller negative. So the S2 is decaying, the contribution because of the S2 is decaying at a much faster pace, or you can say at a much faster rate. Now the critically damped is coming out to be an interesting example in this, because the roots are coming out to be identical. So that particular alpha is equal to omega n. So the roots are identical, or you can say S1 is equal to S2, which is equal to minus of alpha. When say we will be making an observation and substituting this, the equation reduces to the form like this. So purely in terms of mathematical differential arrangements, this is rearranged into the form dy dt di upon dt plus alpha I plus alpha as a common di upon dt plus alpha I is equal to 0. So what basically we did, that this 2 alpha di upon dt term is represented as alpha di upon dt plus alpha di upon dt likewise. Now we are having a liberty to make a choice, so let us take di upon dt plus alpha I is equal to f. So f is a general function. Now correspondingly, this particular equation reduces to the form d upon dt of f plus alpha f is equal to 0. Now please be mindful that this particular equation is exactly the same as we obtained in the first order response arrangement, whether it is a RC or RL. So the general solution of this comes out to be like f is equal to k1 e to the power minus alpha t. This we will be substituting here. So what it is corresponding, di upon dt plus alpha I is equal to f, or you can say di upon dt plus alpha I is equal to k1 e to the power minus alpha t. So this e to the power alpha t is a premultiplier, we did it. So this particular left hand side equation reduces to the d upon dt of e to the power alpha t I, where say the right hand side reduces to only the k1. This we will be doing the integration, so it is giving rise to the arrangement of a coefficient I is equal to k2 plus k1t e to the power minus t. So k1t will be the arrangement here, plus k2 will be the coefficient of integration. This e to the power minus alpha t is coming out to be, because this particular term is a e to the power minus alpha t is a premultiplier here. Now the response is also decaying, but both are not having say the exponential arrangement as such. One particular is also a function of time, which is you can say increasing linearly. And so now the underdamped, it is, you can say, when say the alpha is less than omega n, so under this particular condition the damping coefficient comes out to be lower than 1. So what we will be seeing, when say alpha is less than omega n, so the term because of this square root, within this square root will be negative, or you can say they will be contributing the complex and conjugate roots. So S1, S2 is likewise. So these particular roots are complex and conjugate. When say we will be substituting the previous expression, general expression of k1 e to the power s1t plus k2 e to the power s2t, this equation reduces to the form. So what it is suggesting, this particular is decreasing exponentially. So you can say it is exponentially damped, but it is also having the cosine or sine omega t term, so that is oscillatory in nature. So please be mindful that the roots of the characteristic equation, which are decided by the RLC parameters, will be deciding the response, whether it is a damped, or you can say underdamped, overdamped, or critically damped, likewise. Now with this particular background, we can go for the step response analysis. So in the step response, you can say this particular switch is closed at time t is equal to t0 or t is equal to 0. So before that, this particular is having, say, the initial values of inductor current and the capacitor voltage as it is. Now this particular is the KVL equation. When say the switch is closed, that particular is rearranged into the form. When say we are doing a second order derivative, so this particular will be the equation. Here say the current I, or you can say the inductor current I, is a variable. So this equation is coming out to be the same as we have obtained for the source free, or you can say under the natural response consideration. However, if suppose say we will be making use of the identity I is equal to C dVcdt, that is the relation between the capacitor voltage and the current, so the equation can be translated into the form with say the capacitor voltage as a state variable, then the equation reduces to the like this. So this particular, on say the right hand side, there will be a term which is pertaining to the step input supply voltage. Now the equation formulations are coming out to be the same, whether say this particular or this, both will be corresponding to the characteristic equation. If suppose say we are going for the parallel RLC, then the KCL holds true. So the IS is equal to IR plus IL plus IC. That particular is resulting into the form, equations are rearranged. So here say the variable as the capacitor voltage. So this particular is of a similar nature as that of a source free natural response arrangement. However, if suppose we are making a substitution like this, so the equation is coming out to be as a forced response. So whether you will be solving by this or this, the answers are coming out to be the same. Only difference is how we are applying the initial conditions and computation of derivatives. Now here we have seen the characteristics equation for the series and the parallel arrangement. So they are summed up likewise. They are summed up here as well. So as a choice of variable, we will be writing into a standard form. So this particular is a2d² x/dt² plus a1 dx/dt plus a0x(t) is equal to b0f(t) likewise. Now just as a building block, we will be rewriting this into the form likewise. We can make a comparison. So this particular is resulting into the standard equation, second order equation, and so on. So with this arrangement, you can easily identify that the omega n is coming out to be root of a0 upon a2. Damping ratio is coming out to be a1 upon 2 multiplied by root of 1 upon a0 a2. And DC gain k of s is equal to b0 upon a2. Now, the characteristic equation corresponding to this is the similar one. However, the total response with the step input will be consisting of two terms. One is the steady state response and another one is the transient response. So you please be mindful that this relationship is, or this interpretation is coming out to be on the similar line as we discussed for the first order response. This equation has been developed likewise as an example for the parallel RLC. Similar arrangement can be worked out for the series RLC as well, likewise. So now, the total response for the overdamped, critically damped or the underdamped, because these are the three cases which are decided by the damping ratio as under the consideration. If suppose we are making use of zeta omega n as alpha, so this particular can be explained with the term of alpha likewise. So as keeping this particular definition in mind, the total response is coming out to be steady state response IS plus the transient response as we discussed in case of natural response characteristics likewise. However, in this, the coefficients k1 and k2 are to be calculated judiciously, or you can say carefully. Similarly, the case of critically damped, so this is the steady state response, or you can say a step input plus this is the transient response likewise. So this process is the same whether it is a critically damped case, underdamped or the overdamped case. Now, the behavior of these particular damping has to be analyzed. So, let us look how we will be having the arrangement. Now, first is the case of the underdamped. So, underdamped is happening as discussed that it is having a exponentially damped or decaying response, but oscillatory in nature. So just like this particular is the arrangement. Here say the final value is coming out to be corresponding to the step input, but it is having say the overshoot and the undershoot likewise. So that particular is making a distinction between the, or you can say distinguishing the underdamped with the other two critically or the overdamped cases. Now the critically damped is a choice. So in the case of critically damped, both the roots are coming out to be equal to alpha minus alpha. However, the response is k1 plus k2t into e to the power minus alpha t. So one particular is having say the increasing with the time likewise. So this critically damped, they are having say the approaching to the steady state final value more rapidly in comparison to the overdamped case. This particular is a overdamped response. So the overdamped is because of the two negative values. One particular is large, another one is a smaller one. So the large negative is decaying much rapidly, and this particular response is mostly because of the smaller negative values likewise. Now here say the damping is important, so the behavior is represented for the different damping characteristics. So this is also including the underdamped, critically damped and the overdamped as such. However, when say the damping is zero, so that particular is coming out to be the undamped response. And please be mindful, this damping is contributed because of the resistance. So when say the resistance is not existing in the circuit, the damping term will be zero and the energy will keep on exchanging from the inductor to the capacitor and then capacitor to inductor likewise. So the response ideally will be a sinusoidal arrangement. So depending on the damping levels, etc., this as say the damping is increasing, this is coming out to be underdamped case, and the response is will be of decaying nature but oscillatory in nature, so that particular is reflected. Zeta is equal to 1 corresponds to the critically damped, zeta is equal to 2 is the, you can say, overdamped case. So this overdamped is resulting into the sluggish response. Now one important observation which we can see from this, as say the damping value is coming out to be lower, then the overshoot is high likewise. So here say the intention is to have an analogy between the various mechanical systems and the electrical system. So as an example, we have considered the translational motion. There are two analogy, one is the force voltage analogy, another one is the force current analogy. Force voltage is pertaining to the series RLC equivalent, where say the force current analogy is on the line of parallel RLC. Similar analogous terms can be decided for say the other physical systems, like say the rotational motion, even say the thermal system, even say the fluid flow arrangement likewise. So the point here is, whatever say the interpretation that we made with the help of electrical equivalent circuit, the interpretation can be done for the other physical systems while establishing the analogous parameters. We have to carefully calculate the initial conditions, which are the initial values of voltage and current and its derivative. Characteristic equations are the reflection of circuit physical parameters and the interconnection, like say RLC parameter and the series or parallel combination which we discussed. However, the characteristic equations are independent to whether the case is of step input or the source free response. The damping effect is due to the presence of the resistance. This particular damping determines the rate at which the response is damped. So when say the damping coefficient value is small, the rate of decrease is also smaller. So when say the value of the resistance is zero, that particular is coming out to be the case of undamped response. Correspondingly, zeta value will be zero, and it will be resulting into a purely LC circuit, where say the natural frequency of oscillation will be exactly equal to the undamped natural frequency, and that value will be 1 upon root LC. So therefore, the response will not only be undamped but also oscillatory in nature. Due to this oscillatory response, the energy will keep on changing from the inductor and the capacitor. So this particular situation arises when say there are two different type of circuit, or you can say energy storage elements, inductance and the capacitance. With the same initial condition, the overdamped has the longest settling time. So for the fastest response without oscillation, the critically damped circuits be preferred. Next, we will be going for the AC circuit analysis. For further reading, you can refer these particular textbook or any other supplementary materials. Thank you.